Hey gang, welcome back to the 2020 CrossFit Games Open tips and advice. It's a repeat, protect your back. Hey. 20.3 is a repeat from 18.4. The workout is 21:59 of deadlifts and handstand push-ups, Diane, right into 21:59 of a heavier deadlift and a 50-foot handstand walk. Be sure to go to games.crossfit.com for the full workout details and standards, and also make sure that you're familiar with the handstand push-up standard. It's a little bit different than what we've seen in the past. All right, there's a lot to cover, so let's jump right into the meat of this thing. Really quick, because you know how important warm-up is to me. Start with a light mobility session. We just wanna make sure that we're able to move well during this workout. And then from there, move into a light dynamic cardio warm-up. Do something that has multiple movements. I might even do some burpees and kettlebell swings myself, just something to load the posterior chain and warm up the shoulders as well. So just find something with a lot of dynamic range. And then after your light warm-up, I'd consider building to the heaviest deadlift you'll see in the workout, or at least something that's close to it, and do that for a few reps. Then I would go through just a few small, like pared down portions of the workout. So maybe a few handstand pushups, then a few deadlifts, a few heavier deadlifts, and a couple handstand walks. Just something to get you familiar and start to build good movement pattern. And then it's 3, 2, 1, let's go. There's also a few key things that I think that we should keep in mind throughout this workout. First of all, there's a clear objective that we have to hit in this workout, and that's the handstand pushup mark. Make sure you're hitting that. Second, we must approach this workout with discipline. We don't want to dig ourselves a hole, so be disciplined early on. You really should feel like you're holding yourself back on the first workout. Ideally, we would get to the second half of this workout with a lot of energy left. It's a big finish. But keep in mind that there is a tie break for some individuals. If you can't deadlift the heavy barbell weight and you wanna do this workout RX, or you can't handstand walk, your objective is to get through the first half of this workout as quickly as possible. Then you just take the heavy barbell as it comes. So essentially, you're trying to PR your Diane, which is exactly what Genesee did in 2018. A couple other things to remember in this workout, please keep a tight core. I would suggest wearing a belt as well. You'll thank yourself for it later. Okay, let's talk about some suggested approaches. First, for the general RX community, the first deadlift weight, we wanna take in manageable sets. Ideally, we don't wanna get down to singles. And we also wanna approach it at a rate that will allow us to kick up to the handstand pushups fairly quickly. And then we get to the handstand pushups in this first workout. Let's aim for 3 to 4 sets. You don't have to do it unbroken. Come down, choose your breaks, and if you're ready, just go right back up. The goal is to not spike your heart rate here. We wanna have a lot of energy left for the second half of this workout. And then for masters who are doing push press, try not to get too much muscle fatigue on the push press, so you have some energy and stamina for the handstand pushups later on in the workout. When you get into workout 2, when you approach the deadlifts, keep in mind that we want to get to the handstand walk. That is a separator in this workout. But on the deadlifts, we have to be smart. We're increasing the weight and we're doing another 45 reps. So approach it smart. Every set, leave room for the ability to pick the bar right back up after you drop it. You just wanna have that in mind. I could pick this back up right now if I wanted to. And then when you get to the handstand walk, break this down into 5-foot segments. Do not look at the handstand walk as 25-foot sections that you're gonna try to accomplish. Just take it piece by piece. Every 5 feet is one rep. Don't get greedy. All right, for the competitors, when you get to workout 1, remember that you have a lot of work on the back end of this workout. So when you approach the first set of deadlifts, just don't wear yourself out. And then for the competitors, your handstand pushups, be accurate. That's vital in this workout. We don't want to do any more reps than we have to. We're likely going to be doing the handstand pushups unbroken though. But do keep in mind, you're going to feel like you're holding back a little bit. And then you're going to get to that second heavy deadlift. You're going to be doing a total of 45 reps at a pretty heavy barbell. Be smart. For your handstand walk, walking rate really matters. If you're starting to slow down during your handstand walk, then kick down. The goal is not to do this in unbroken 25-foot sections. The goal is to do this workout as fast as possible. And then for the scale division, take a look at some of the things I said for the other communities, but remember, you also can push the deadlifts a little bit faster in the first workout. Because when you get to the hand release push-ups, you can catch your breath there. Just think, find a rhythm. Maybe it's push, drop, breathe, go again. Whatever that looks like, just find a rhythm that you can stay steady in and lower your heart rate so you can get back to the devs and start to push those. And then on your second workout, you can grit your teeth and do some bear crawls. Let's get through those deadlifts. Let's get to that second barbell and really start to put our foot down. This portion of the workout is where we can really put the pedal to the metal. And for your bear crawls, remember to keep breathing and remind yourself that though my shoulders are burning, I can keep going. Just one foot, actually, in this case, one hand in front of the other. I want you to have a lot of fun and enjoy your community. Smile and high five after this, but by all means, please do yourself a favor. And after this workout, take 10 to 15 minutes and cool down. I suggest foam rolling these muscle groups for just 2 minutes a piece. Do your hamstrings on each side, your glutes on each side, and then your back. And I suggest hugging yourself and rolling your back on the foam roller a little bit. Just take 10 minutes. You're gonna feel a whole lot better the next day if you do that. All right, gang, you know the drill. Go have fun, go crush this workout, enjoy your friends, and I will see you guys on the leaderboard. See you later.
Are you done? Clearly not.
Can I get the doggy treat? That's weird. I'm flowing, girl. I'm
no,
going. We can really do some things that will behoove us in our warm up. I thought it was a good word. Don't look at me like that. Behoove. Who uses that? All of our body and mobility is functioning well. How does your mobility function?
Makes no sense.
That makes no sense. If I will wear a belt, no, I don't want to just cut that out. There's a lot of varying opinions on this. That doesn't need to be said either. We'll cut that.
Hey, you're getting better.
Hey, thanks.